Hi, I'm Teacher Daisy. Today, I'm going to teach you Exercise Computer Form 2, Chapter 1.2. I will explain this subject in English and Malay. However, the exam is using Malay, so you need to remember the terms in Malay. Let's start now. 1.2 Sistem Nombor Perenambelasan. In this chapter, you will learn Sistem Nombor Perenambelasan and Sistem Nombor Perpuluhan. The conversion between nombor perenambelasan and nombor perpuluhan, and also the conversion between nombor perenambelasan and nombor perduaan. After that, you will learn convert pengekodan ASCII to nombor perenambelasan based on the given aksara, and the relationship between nombor perenambelasan and kod ASCII in Bahasa Mesin. Nombor perenambelasan versus nombor perpuluhan. Before that, what are the system nombor you had learned? In Form 1 Chapter 2.1, we have learned system nombor perduaan and system nombor perpuluhan. And in Form 2 Chapter 1.1, we have learned system nombor perlapanan. And now, we will learn a new system nombor, which is nombor perenambelasan. Nombor perenambelasan is system asas 16, which use 0 to 9 and A to F. The subscript of nombor perenambelasan is 16. For example, nombor perenambelasan 4A is written as 4A, and at the right bottom, you need to write down 16 to indicate that this is a nombor perenambelasan. So what is the use of nombor perenambelasan? Why do we need to learn it? Nombor perenambelasan can use to represent nombor perduaan 0 and 1, X as Bahasa Mesin. It can convert to nombor perduaan and vice versa easily. Besides that, nombor perenambelasan can represent nombor perduaan in a shorter and neater way. Moreover, nombor perenambelasan can use to represent color on digital devices in RGB color model. For RGB color model, each color is represented by two nombor perenambelasan. That is, each color has as many as 16 to the power of 2 equals to 256 variance color. Overall, the amount of color spectrum that can be represented is 256 red times 256 green times 256 blue equals to more than 16 million colors. Let us look at the example of the nombor perenambelasan color code and its color. FF0000 is red. AB10CD is purple. Furthermore, nombor perenambelasan also used for the basic development of system micro pump process. Let's say your computer suddenly crashed and show this image. All the message ralat about the location of computer memory are shown in nombor perenambelasan, so that system developers can base on the nombor perenambelasan to identify and fix the ralat. Well, for nombor perpuluhan is system asas 10, which use digit 0 to 9. The subscript of nombor perpuluhan is 10. For example, nombor perpuluhan 74 is written as 74, and at the right bottom, you need to write down 10 to indicate that this is a nombor perpuluhan. Humans use nombor perpuluhan widely in their daily life. Conversion of nombor perpuluhan to nombor perenambelasan. Let us look at an example. Using method kaedah bahagi dengan 16 dan gunakan bakinya. Convert the nombor perpuluhan 423 to nombor perenambelasan. 423 divided by 16 equals to 26 with the remainder 7. use the value 26 and divide it by 16 again, we'll get 1 with the remainder 10. In nombor perenambelasan, 10 is 8. Repeat the step until you get 0 in the end. Now, we can get the nombor perenambelasan by reading the nombor from bottom to top. Therefore, the nombor perpuluhan 423 is equal to 1A7 in nombor perenambelasan. Conversion of nombor perenambelasan to nombor perpuluhan. Let's look at another example. Convert the nombor perenambelasan 4F3 to nombor perpuluhan. First, draw out a table. After that, write down the nombor perenambelasan 4F3. Then, write down the nilai tempat from right to left. Nilai tempat for nombor perenambelasan is base 16, with the exponent start from 0 and increment by 1. So, 16 to the power of 0 is 1. 16 to the power of 1 is 16. 16 to the power of 2 is 256. Nilai digit is nombor perenambelasan times nilai tempat. Lastly, nombor perpuluhan is add up all the nilai digit. Therefore, the nombor perenambelasan 4F3 is nombor perpuluhan 1267. Next, we go to conversion of nombor perenambelasan to nombor perduaan. Look at the table below. The table represents every nombor perenambelasan with 4-digit nombor perduaan. We will learn the conversion through an example. Convert nombor perenambelasan 9F2 to nombor perduaan. Write down nombor perenambelasan 9F2. Split every digit into one column. After that, refer the table. 9 is 1001. F is 1111. 2 is 0010. Then, combine the number together, we'll get 1001 1111 0010. Therefore, nombor perenambelasan 9F2 is equal to nombor perduaan 1001 1111 0010. Conversion of nombor perduaan to nombor perenambelasan. There are two kaedah to convert nombor perduaan to nombor perenambelasan. First kaedah is kaedah pengumpulan 4 digit nombor perduaan dan tukarkan kepada nilai perenambelasan. Let us learn by an example. Convert nombor perduaan 11110011010 to nombor perenambelasan. First, write down the nombor perduaan from right to left. After that, group the nombor perduaan 4 in one group. If the left group still left empty space, we just need to fill in with 0. After that, refer the table. 0111 is 7, 1001 is 9, and 1010 is 8. Therefore, nombor perduaan 11110011010 is nombor perenambelasan 798. The second kaedah of converting nombor perduaan to nombor perenambelasan is kaedah pengiraan. Let us learn with the same example. Convert nombor perduaan 11110011010 to nombor perenambelasan. First, write down the nombor perduaan from right to left. After that, group the nombor perduaan 4 in one group. Let's say the left group still left empty space. We just need to fill in with 0. After that, write down the nilai tempat from right to left in the group. 2 to the power of 0 is 1. 2 to the power of 1 is 2. 2 to the power of 2 is 4. 2 to the power of 3 is 8. After that, do the same things for the rest of the groups. Then, nilai darab is nombor times nilai tempat. nilai tambah is add up all the nilai darab for every group. And lastly, the nombor perenambelasan is the result of nilai tambah. Therefore, nombor perduaan 1111001100 is equal to nombor perenambelasan 798. You can see that both kaedah will give you the same result. After that, you will learn convert pengekodan ASCII to nombor perenambelasan based on the given aksara. First of all, what is ASCII? Pengekodan ASCII is one of the most widely used system pengekodan in the world of computing. ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Kod ASCII are used to represent text in computers and other communication devices. The main kod ASCII are in the form of nombor perpuluhan. There are two kaedah to convert pengekodan ASCII to nombor perenambelasan based on the given aksara. First kaedah, bahagi dengan 16 dan gunakan bakinya. This method is same as in 1.2.2.1. Example, convert the aksara A from kod ASCII to nombor perenambelasan. The kod ASCII A is nombor perpuluhan 97. 97 divided by 16 equals to 6 with the remainder 1. Use the value 6 and divide it by 16 again, we'll get 0 with the remainder 6. Since we get 0 already, so we can get the nombor perenambelasan by reading the nombor from bottom to top. Therefore, the aksara D A is nombor perenambelasan 61. Now, let us look at the second kaedah. The second kaedah is merujuk kepada lampiran A. Example, convert the aksara D from kod ASCII of a nombor perpuluhan to nombor perenambelasan. The kod ASCII D is nombor perpuluhan 68. Therefore, the aksara D is nombor perenambelasan 44. Let us move on to the relationship between nombor perenambelasan and kod ASCII in Bahasa Mesin. Aturcara can be written in various bahasa pengaturcaraan, such as Scratch, C++, Java, Visual Basic, and Python. However, computers cannot understand these codes directly. Therefore, program codes need to be translated into Bahasa Mesin so that computer can understand. Basically, Bahasa Mesin is also known as Kod Mesin. It is a basic language that computers can understand because it only consists of nombor perduaan, 0 and 1. Sistem Piawai ASCII allows computer components from different manufacturers to work properly in a computer. Example, convert the word bakti from a nombor perpuluhan kod ASCII to nombor perenambelasan. The word bakti has 5 aksara. One aksara has 8 nombor perduaan. So 5 aksara has 40 digit nombor perduaan. While the word bakti for nombor perenambelasan is 42, 41, 4d, 54, 49, one aksara has 2 nombor perenambelasan, so 5 aksara has 10 digit nombor perenambelasan. Therefore, from this example, we can see that represent the aksara in nombor perenambelasan is much more shorter than in nombor perduaan. If you find this video is helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And if you got any question, can comment below. Thanks for watching.